हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द सेम चैप्टर दैट इज रिप्रोडक्शन इन एनिमल्स एंड द टॉपिक इज मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स। नाउ मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स, मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू पार्ट्स, टेस्टिस एंड पेनिस। यू कैन सी द डायग्राम ऑफ मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन फ्रॉम योर बुक, ह्यूमन मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, इट्स रिटन। So, it consists of testes and penis. Now, what is the function of testes? You can see testes in the diagram. These testes are embedded in a very in a skin called scrotum. That skin that is present on these testes is known as scrotum. And then we have bladder, that is urinary bladder. Now, this vast difference, that is the connecting pipe that connect testes to the urinary bladder. Now this bladder is urinary bladder, and then we have uterus, and then we have penis. Now these testes, they produce male gametes. Male gametes are sperm, so they produce and store sperms in it. Then penis, these sperms are released through penis out of the body of the male body. Then male sex hormone is known as testosterone. Now female reproductive organs, on next page female reproductive system is given, diagram is given there. You can see it has three parts: ovaries, fallopian tubes and uterus. Now ovaries, they occur in pair and they produce ova or egg cell, that is female gamete. Now fallopian tube, now egg is released in the fallopian tube. Now when egg is formed, it goes to fallopian tube. वो fallopian tube में जाता है और वहाँ पर वो wait करता है till the fertilization takes place. And for 3 to 4 days, and if fertilization do not takes place, then this egg is damaged. उसे फिर से damage हो जाता है वो, that is damaged, and that goes out of the body. Now uterus, uterus, you can see the diagram, uterus is there. Now once the egg is fertilized or the cell is fertilized, then it is embedded in the uterus. Fir wo uterus mein aa jata hai, then it move to uterus from fallopian tube, aur wo uterus mein agle 9 months ke liye rehta hai. It remain in uterus for the next 9 months, and that period is known as gestation period. And embryo grows here, and inside uterus there is placenta. Ek naya organ form hota hai, that is placenta. And this placenta, it is a link between uterus and the developing embryo. Embryo, I mean to say zygote develops into embryo. Humne kiya tha na, male and female gamete joined together or fused together to form zygote. Now zygote develops into an embryo. Now this embryo, this is embedded in uterus. उसे uterus में रहना होता है अगले 9 months के लिए, तो उसे oxygen भी चाहिए और food भी चाहिए, वो कौन देगा? That is placenta. Placenta uterus और embryo के बीच में link होता है, वो उसे oxygen और nutrient provide करता है. Now female sex hormone is known as estrogen. These are male and female reproductive organs. In your book, gamete, the diagram of gamete is also given, male gamete and female gamete. You can see female gamete, it is circular in shape, and the male gamete, it has head, middle piece and tail. Now fertilization, as we all know, fusion of female and male gamete, that is male gamete is sperm and female gamete is ovum or ova. They both fuse together and give rise to zygote. After fertilization, zygote is formed. Now zygote, this fertilization, this fusion takes place in oviduct, and once sperm and ova both fuse together, they form zygote, and then this zygote goes into uterus and stay in uterus for the next 9 months, and that period is known as gestation period. Now this fertilization takes place inside the oviduct. Now the new individual is formed. Now the new individual that is formed, that will inherit few characters of mother and few characters of father, because half of the chromosomes are from mother and half of the chromosomes are from father. So this is the whole process of fertilization. Few topics are still left in this chapter, that is oviparous and viviparous organism. Oviparous and viviparous organism. Now oviparous organisms are those organisms that do not give rise to young ones, they lay eggs. जो एगलिंग एनिमल्स या बर्ड्स होते हैं उन्हें हम कहते हैं ओविपैरस. एग्जाम्पल बर्ड्स एंड स्नेक, दीज आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ओविपैरस. विविपैरस द इंडिविजुअल दैट गिव बर्थ टू यंग वंस, जो बेबी को बर्थ करते हैं उन्हें हम कहते हैं हम विविपैरस. एग्जाम्पल ह्यूमन बींग्स, एलिफेंट्स, दीज आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ विविपैरस एनिमल्स. One more thing is there, that is external and internal fertilization. External fertilization and internal fertilization. Now external fertilization, as the name suggests, that means something that is occurring outside our body. That means fusion of male and female gamete occur outside the female body. That is known as external fertilization. Example is, mostly it happens in aquatic animals or amphibians like frog, fish, they exhibit external fertilization. That means fusion of male and female gamete takes place outside the female body. If you talk about internal fertilization, fusion of male and female gamete takes place inside the body. Like in human beings, where the fusion of ovum and sperm takes place? It takes place in oviduct. So it is internal fertilization. Example, human beings. Now the chapter is over. Please complete your home assignments. Thank you.